She's answering the highest law enforcement.
We hear Black Lives Matters for other people and makes us angry because when you look at a Ferguson.
Why would it make you angry if someone says
because
a life matters?
Because it infers that people don't think Black Lives Matter.
Black Lives Matter.
It should make you angry that a life matters.
Look, of course, all lives matter. What I'm saying is
stop.
The language that comes out is so negative towards police, and the Black Lives Matters movement that was so vocal in Ferguson took the side of a bully who bullied a minority shopkeeper, beat up a cop, and then got killed because of his own actions.
So let me ask
and
you
the hands up, don't shoot was a lie.
Can I ask using you, can the I ask same you, argument hold on, hold on. About for police, that's, you're using the same argument that you're saying but that people in Black Lives Matter say about police, and you're saying, you're painting the whole movement as negative when you think the people in Black Lives Matter are painting the whole all police officers as negative, and that's not what's happening.
The name Black Lives Matter.
You're talking past each other.
All lives matter. It's just saying, we know what you're insinuating.
What are we insinuating?
You're insinuating that young black men are targets and that the police are racist and they target
young black
men.
Nobody's saying that. That's why you're missing it. That is why,
hold on, because Black Lives Matter.
Let me tell you, as a young black male, let me tell you what it means so we can have an
and
education.
I'm not a young black male?
So,
all right, go ahead.
No, you're not. So we have an educational moment here because there is a very specific pain that many African-American males, just people, because Sandra Bland was not an African-American male. I have to say her name as well, that are going through. And you can bring up the example of Ferguson all you want, right?
But I can tell you,
it's not just Eric Garner. It's not just Walter Scott. It's not just Tamir Rice. The list goes on and on
when
and
you
on.
Have, I look, there are things that need to be looked at. No doubt about it. There are racial issues in our criminal justice
but.
System.
Don't say but. Because it
but
negates
you
everything
have,
you say before.
When you have people taking to the streets, yelling, we want dead cops, and then a week later,
so
no, let me finish.
Is
please,
the Tea
I
Party racist because
please,
people
Bakari,
say that,
let me
go
finish
ahead,
my
please,
point.
Go ahead.
You have them chanting, a whole group of people, we want dead cops, and 1 week later, Wen Jin Liu dies, along with his partner, dies, slaughtered, assassinated. You have them yelling, pigs in a blanket, frying like bacon, a group of people shouting this. And then you have police officer blood spilled on the streets. All lives matter. Black lives matter. White lives matter. All
but that's,
lives
we're not, we
matter.
Don't have, we don't lives. Have a question right now about the value of young white males' lives in this country. But there is a serious question about the value of young black males'
and
lives.
And police
this,
lives.
And,
and,
I, and you
questioning.
Know what's amazing about
nobody's
that?
Questioning those lives.
Yes, they are. Every Ooh. Single day because of the simple fact they don't get the benefit of their humanity. Because you can go out there and there are many things that you can do and get shot while being black in this
let me
country.
Ask you this.
And that is a point, and that is a fact. All I'm saying,
let me ask
that's
you
not a
question.
Viewpoint.
He has a different if all this was happening under 8 years of a Trump organization, a Trump administration, we'd be blaming it on him. Obama's getting a pass.
Obama's getting to explain
it.
That. No, say more.
He doesn't address
you just can't say that. He doesn't address it.
Let me tell you something.
No, go ahead. Explain
all the stuff.
I want to hear why.
All the stuff y'all read about in history books, I lived it. I was born in the 50s. I was raised in the 60s. My very first experience with police was getting beat up by cops when I was 11 years old. So all the stuff y'all read about, I lived through it.
So
and I'm seeing the same conditions being repeated now under this Democratic administration. In the 60s, blacks couldn't get an education, blacks couldn't get jobs, blacks were riding in the streets, and blacks were getting beat up by the police. And here it is, 2016, blacks can't get jobs, our graduation rate is lower since it's been since 1963, we're getting beat up by the police, and we're riding in
how
the
about
streets.
This? How
with
about
8 years
how about
of a Democratic
this? What
administration.
What if I gave you those facts, which I will just give you those facts for the purposes of the discussion because we run a long time. How's Donald Trump going to fix them? What are his plans?
It's not about
Donald
Trump.
No, it is.
No, it's not.
No, you just said it.
Listen. It's
just said it.
No, right now, this is about Barack Obama. This ain't about. So, this conversation doesn't need to be had with Donald Trump. It needs to be had on Pennsylvania Avenue.
And it's been had with Barack Obama because
then what's the result? Black folks still getting shot every week.
That's why we're talking about reforming the criminal justice system.
Let me ask you a question. Why doesn't Barack Obama simply say, why don't y'all stop?
Y'all who?
Y'all black folks that's killing people.
What do you...
Listen,
did
why
you
doesn't...
Just say that
listen,
in front of the world?
Listen.
Say that again
why doesn't,
the world.
Why doesn't Barack Obama make it a point to say, I want this to stop?
What?
Please
stop.
You know what, man.
You know what? Tell me. Use your words. Listen, what?
No, tell him.
What? No, what?
You know what?
Go ahead.
What?
What's been happening in the last 2 weeks?
What? You act like Barack Obama's been condoning...
Let him talk.
No, what?
Listen,
you see the way Donald Trump does rallies? If I'm Barack Obama... I'm going city to city to city to where I think the hotbeds are and saying, please, let's stop this violence. Let's stop this confusion. Let's stop this disunity. Let's stop this. Let's not do this.
What has he been
let's
saying?
Let's not do this.
What has he been
let's
saying?
Let's not do this. And he's been reactive and not proactive.
He's been very proactive. I mean, Barack Obama
name one proactive thing he's
Barack
done.
First of all, Barack Obama has brought these groups together so that we can
what
put
groups?
Together a plan. The Ferguson Commission, so that you could talk about
what forming groups has he brought
the
together?
The Ferguson Commission.
He brought them together with who?
So that is the name of that is the commission.
Okay,
I would, it's the 21st century
commission. Okay, and what does it do? What has it done?
And they actually laid out a plan to reform the
criminal justice. And what good did it do?
Oh, they're implementing that throughout
and
the country.
And what good did it do?
It's doing. I mean, what,
and so we have a funeral for five dead cops after that, huh?
You think the problem is that you think that I can't pray for them and pray for the people who die in in Minneapolis and Baton Rouge?
It's not working.
So what is Donald Trump going to do? Answer the question.
Hey, when he's president, we'll find out. What do you mean? Answer
what do you
the question.
Mean? We'll find out.
I don't speak for everything Donald Trump
right.
does.
That's a sad commentary, bro.
It's not.
I gotta go.
Commentary.
Thank you.
I don't speak for everything Donald Trump
thank
does.
You. If you're not
Donald
up
Trump
at watching
do.
This show at 2 a.m, you ain't nothing.
Like I know everything Donald Trump is going to do. You know everything. You know everything Hillary Clinton's going to do.
I'm a pressure.
Do you know everything Hillary Clinton's going to do?
Let me tell you one thing that I
promise. Do you know everything Hillary Clinton's going to do?
Can I promise you something?
No, you don't. So stop.
I'm gonna promise you that I'm going to challenge her on issues
do you know
that are near and dear to my heart every single day.
Everything she's going to do.
I know something.
Do you know everything?
We'll be right back.
Okay, then.